All right, hello and welcome to another Expert Insight interview. My name is John Golden from SalesPOP Online, Sales Magazine and Pipeliner CRM. And today I am joined by Stu Schlackman, who is in Texas. Stuart, correct?
Yep, Dallas, Texas.
Excellent. And after more than 30 years in corporate sales, Stuart formed his own training company, and he's helped deliver great results to a lot of different companies. And he's written a number of books. And one of the most interesting ones is Four People You Should Know. And this is where he has actually been able to codify different personality types that you may end up, you know, having to sell to. So I thought today it'd be a great idea with Stu here is to talk about those four personality types. And before we get into that, Stuart, how did you come up with these four personality types in the first place?
Well, there's a couple of models out there that are very similar. True Colors is one of them, Insight Learning Foundation. And what I did back years ago was figure out, having a sales background, how can I use this in my selling efforts? Because it's not about how I sell that matters. It's about how my client buys.
Right.
So that's what I kind of devised and put together. So it's all based on four components. What does the client value? How do they make decisions? What motivates them to action? And how do they prefer to communicate? So that's what I came up with it. And I've been doing it for about 13 years now. It's been going pretty well.
Excellent. Okay, so let's dive in. So there's four different colors. There's blue, gold, green, and orange. Okay,
right.
So let's start off with the blue personality. What's particular about that?
The blue personality is the relationship person. Mm-hmm. The most important thing is relationships, family, loved ones, friends. Blues are the best at selling themselves to the client, and they build it around trust, integrity, and honesty. They believe in delivering great service. They always put the customer or the client first. And so they are the relationship personality style. They're part of the two that are what we call right brain personalities.
Mm-hmm. And what are so those are all good traits, right? You know, they want to build relationships, trust. And what are some maybe of the downsides of the blue personality?
Well, the blue personality has a hard time saying no. Mm-hmm. They will avoid conflict like the plague. They do not like conflict. They're very good at collaboration, compromise. They want to please their pleasers, but they're also slow in making decisions. And sometimes it's difficult for the blue personality to be direct.
Right.
And there are two personalities that are very direct, and they can have a hard time with that.
So if a blue personality seller meets a blue personality buyer, is that a match made in heaven, or can that get sidetracked very easily?
It's a good match, but here's the problem. Blues are slow at making decisions. So when two blues get together, it might take a long time before anything's accomplished.
But they're going to have a fantastic relationship.
They're going to have a great time. Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely.
So obviously, I mean, blue personalities, if you were managing a blue personality seller, you obviously want to maximize that relationship building element and that trust building element, but you probably want to help them move things along.
Help them move things along. Help them focus on getting decisions made. Help them be a little bit more assertive versus passive. They tend to be more laid back, more passive than a gold or an orange that are way more aggressive.
Because it always reminds me of one of those things. When I would be interviewing for salespeople, often I'd get some that would say, "Oh yeah, I'm a great relationship builder. You know, my customers become my friends." And I'd always go, "That's great, but I don't really want them to be your friends. I want them to be loyal, repeat, happy customers."
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Yeah. And blues are very good at having long-lasting relationships. Mm-hmm. They're excellent at that.
So, so the gold personality, what's different about that?
Okay, so your gold personality is one of the two left brain personalities, the gold and the green. The gold is all about organization, process, planning, discipline, structure. They live a scheduled life. They live by agendas. They're not that flexible, but they get things done. They put together a time frame. They get it done. Golds like to look at the pros and the cons of a situation, and they like to measure by comparison. but they're very disciplined, they're very focused, they could be aggressive, and they're extremely direct. So if a gold is talking to a gold, things are going to get done. But if it's gold to a blue or gold to a green, it could get a little some sparks there.
So what are the how does a gold personality sell, especially in an environment where maybe things are not as, you know, things are never as orderly or organized as you would like them to be? How does that affect how they sell?
Well, where the blue sells themselves, the gold sells the company they work for, the prestige, the longevity, the security and stability of their products and services. So that's what they're going to sell to the client. And if they're coming into a disarray or unorganized situation, they're going to be good at organizing it and putting together a polished PowerPoint on the presentation that needs to be given to show the value of the solution. Goals are very financial oriented, return on investment, internal rate of return, you know, profit margin. They're very good with the numbers, being a left brain person, but they're very direct. They could be very aggressive. They tend to like to do the talking, where the blue likes to ask questions. Two personalities ask questions, two tend to do the talking.
that's interesting. So does the go personality then, is it a good personality for, like I said, when the buyer may not really have organized their thinking and not really really clear about what they want? Are they good at actually drawing them out and helping them that way?
Yes, especially with great questions. Mm-hmm. And golds are good at asking the right questions.
Right.
And they'll help the customer discern what they need to do. Excellent. So they're good in that aspect, yes.
And obviously the downside of the go personality, as you said, is that they're very direct and lack flexibility. So they're maybe not the most creative. Would that be fair?
Right. They are not. They the blues are the most creative. Mm-hmm. Greens are the most innovative. Oranges are the most imaginative. And the golds don't have any of that. What the golds are good at is taking those other three and making money out of it.
I love it.
And organizing them. That's where the golds are strong. They're very good at that organization side and the structure and the process and the planning.
Perfect. So the green personality.
The green is your analytic. Mm-hmm. Your green is your IT person, your engineer, your doctor, your scientist. They are facts, details, and logic. They tend to be skeptical. They ask more questions than any other personality. Like the blue, they're slow to make a decision because they have to have all the information. They're the type of people, when they go to buy something, if they see the salesperson, they'll pick them apart because they've researched what they're looking for so much that they already know more about the product probably than the salesperson does. So they can ask a lot of tough questions.
So if you're going to sell to a green personality, what's the best approach to take?
Best approach is to be open, understand that they're going to ask a lot of questions, be patient. Mm-hmm. They're not going to buy right away. Ask them, what else can I do for you? What other questions can I answer? When we're done today, I would love to know what you'd like to do for next steps, but I would never push them. You never want to be aggressive with a green. Just like a blue, you will lose them.
Mm-hmm. So it seems then that obviously one of the key things, if you are selling to a green personality, like you say, they're going to ask you a lot of questions, a lot of tough questions. Yep. So you have to not just be prepared, but also be prepared not to get defensive when they start picking you apart, right?
Exactly. The worst thing you can do is get defensive with a green. Mm. Absolutely. You do not want to get defensive. You want to be open. Yeah. You want to invite those questions and say, in fact, you know, share with them, that's a great question, you know, congratulate them on what they're asking. They love that.
And do greens make good salespeople, or are they more like good sales engineers?
They are great at problem solving. Mm-hmm. That's what they sell, is their problem solving expertise. I know a lot of greens in the insurance industry, and they're fantastic at like estate planning,
right?
The details of wills and living wills and they get into the details more so than anybody else, and that's their expertise. That's what they're good at.
Excellent. And then the orange personality.
Yeah. I'm an orange. Oranges sell excitement. They sell the immediate benefits. And they love to beat the competition. They're good at thinking on their feet. And they're persuasive. Like the gold personality, mm-hmm. they're direct. They're more aggressive. But they're more relationship-oriented, like the blue, being another right brain personality. Oranges are very good at thinking on their feet, and they're very good at building the relationship. But they're more, energetic than the other personality styles, and they do things in real time. They want things done right away. They got to be careful not to talk too much because they have to ask good questions, and that's where they could run into trouble.
So would the orange personality be what, say, a lot of people would think of it? That's what a typical salesperson looks like when they think. Yes. Do they think the orange personality?
Yes, absolutely. And there are weaknesses that come with it because oranges tend to focus on themselves. They like to be the center of attention. So when I'm with an orange customer, I have to acquiesce and let them be the total center of attention, and I need to listen and be quiet.
Yeah, and is that difficult? I'm not saying difficult for you because you've been doing it a long time, but is that difficult for a lot of orange personalities?
Yes.
When they're selling and they're selling to an orange person, is it hard for them? Does it become almost a competition of egos?
Yes. It's like, I'll one-up you on telling a story. Right. Oh, that's a great story, but let me tell you about this. And then it goes back and forth. But you got to get to closure.
Right.
You know, you've got to understand what's important to the client and give them what they're looking for. So you got to, oranges need to be a little bit more patient because they are not a patient personality style.
And so if you're selling to an orange person, how do you do that effectively?
You got to move it along. Mm-hmm. They are big picture. They're not into details. You want to give them the immediate benefits and show them how they're going to look good. How they're going to be a hero for making this purchase. And that's what orange is like.
So if you come in to sell to an orange with a 30-slide PowerPoint, they're the ones who are going to say, can we just skip through all this stuff, please?
Just show me how it works. Give me the demonstration. I don't need the PowerPoint. Exactly.
Yeah. And so obviously, I mean, they're all of these personality types kind of are fluid and cross over a little bit to each other. But when you work with people, how do you help them identify, number one, their own personality and also the personality of who they're selling to? Because sometimes they may only have only a little bit of information.
Yeah, excellent point. I have a skill card that identifies what that personality looks like. For instance, if you're a right brain person, a blue and an orange, you're more sociable. Mm-hmm. Left brain, green and gold, are more serious. Now, your oranges and golds tend to do the talking. They're aggressive. They like to dominate. So, and they're fast-paced in their, speaking. Blues and greens are more slow-paced in their speaking and tend to ask questions. Mm-hmm. You'll see that most oranges are extroverted. Most greens are introverted. Blues and golds are about 50-50. As far as dress, blues follow, fashion trends.
Right.
Oranges like to be flashy, casual. They like to be noticed. Golds are conservative. They'll wear a suit and tie even if they don't have to. And greens just dress for functionality, efficiency, and comfort. So I'll look at what they're wearing, and that has part of it too.
And then when you get beyond that, what are some of the early indicators of their personality? What are some of the things, like when you start a conversation, what are some of the cues that you suddenly go, oh, I know who this is?
The words. Like for greens, it's about efficiency, effectiveness, details, logic, parameters. They'll use scientific words. Golds will be about organization, process, planning, judgment, criteria, specifications. Oranges, fast, exciting, moving, benefits, immediate, things like that. And blues, it's about sociable, it's about honesty, trust, integrity, doing what's right, They're risk averse. Mm-hmm. They like safety. Safety is a big word, and security for the orange, for the blue personality. So I listen to, you know, the words they're using, how fast they're talking, how much they're thinking to themselves versus just saying what's on their mind, because golds and oranges just come right out with it, where blues and greens are more hesitant on how they approach you. Greens are more poker faces.
Right.
You cannot tell what they're thinking. And that's just the way they are. Sometimes you might not feel comfortable with them, but they're more low-key, mm-hmm. where it's very obvious when you get with an orange or a gold. They're just outspoken. And yeah. Blues are just warm and friendly.
Mm. And I think these are great things for people to consider, because I always find that you often see salespeople, especially if you're maybe the orange personality, get very uncomfortable if they're interacting with somebody, like with a prospect who maybe needs time to process things. So there are silence, there are gaps, and the probably the orange personality hates those gaps and silence, yes. Right?
Oh, 3 seconds of a pause would be a lifetime for an orange. Somebody always has to be doing the talking.
Right.
You know, I have some good friends that are green, and if we're in the car for 20 minutes together, I feel that I have to be saying something the whole time, because if I don't say anything, they won't say anything. We could go 20 minutes without talking. That drives me crazy.
But in the context of, you know, sometimes when you're in a sales call, somebody like that needs those few seconds to process what and think through what you've just said to them, right? So it's obviously takes some discipline for the orange personality to say, okay, yes. I'm going to give them this moment to think.
Exactly. So if you're an orange or a gold, you need to be more patient. Mm-hmm. And if you're a green or a blue,
you need to hurry up, be
a little bit more direct and aggressive.
Yeah. So somebody was watching this and said, well, I'm building a sales team. I think I should just hire. I'm just going to go and hire orange personalities, because it sounds like they're the go-getters and the people who get everything done. Yeah. What would you say to that person?
Beware. You should not hire people ever based on personality, even though there are attributes that might be better for one sales environment versus another, because I always ask the question in a workshop, who makes the best salesperson? And the oranges scream out, orange. No, the answer is they all do for different reasons.
Right.
You know, the blue sells themselves. The green is the best problem solver. The gold is great at selling the corporation, the solutions, and the structure. And the oranges are exciting, and they sell the immediate benefits. And they're very likable also. So they sell for different reasons. Mm-hmm. It just depends on what type of environment you're in and, who would fit well into that environment.
Yeah, and I guess what type of customers you sell to and whether you have a lot of different type of customers. And maybe, you know, maybe the oranges are great at, you know, barnstorming and getting in the door, but they're not so great once they get in the door. Maybe you need one of the other ones to take over then, right?
Right, like the difference between a farmer and a hunter.
Yeah.
You know, hunters are more aggressive. So your golds and your oranges might do better there, where a blue and a green would be great at farming. But, not exactly. Mm-hmm. It just depends on the environment. Yeah, good point.
All right. Well, this is great. Thanks a lot, Stu. We're just coming up against the end of the time.
Sure.
The book is called 4 People You Should Know. And you can look that up. That's on Amazon. It'll be on SalesPOP as well. And before we go, Stu, how can people find out more about you?
Well, they could go to my website, stuschlackman.com, and my email's there, my phone number's there, and there's a contact page that they could get to me on, and they could see everything I do. I have 200 sales articles. I have YouTube videos that I've downloaded to my website on 90-second snippets of sales skills that are needed. Everything, all aspects of selling.
Perfect. Well, this has been great. I've really enjoyed this. I'm going to spend a little more time investigating those personality types, because I think it's always fascinating to be able to figure out where people are coming from. So again, my name is John Golden, SalesPOP Online Sales Magazine Pipeline and CRM. Stu, thank you very much for talking to us today.
Thank you, John. Appreciate it.